This must have fallen off. That's why it's not working. Just let me fish the tube out of here. Gosh, this is tight. This piece goes on here. So. Now comes the task of trying to figure out how to take this piece off. Alright, Jeep, I'll be back in a second. I have to do another, get some more tools. Alright, Jeep, we got it out. This is the piece I was having troubles. Supposed to be able to slide right on here. Stay there, but unfortunately it slipped off. So I'm not going to worry about this. I'm just going to get a new, use the new one. The new one, full barrel piece, should slide right on in here. Go. Slide it on like that, no problems there. Then first pin, back in. Go. And before I put the second pin in, get this piece put back together. Sorry, knocked the tripod. Alrighty. This is going to be a little bit annoying. Problem is, these two pieces have to stack up just right so they fit on the either side of this to go on the side of these two. So, I'm going to have to do. This piece is going to have to go in like this. This piece is going to have to fit just in like so. Now for this annoying pin, let's see how this works out. I'm going to have to line it up right here. Number one. Number two. And the second one is right here. It might be lined up enough for it to work. Pin. Oh, never mind. No, it's not. Just our end caps. Hold on, I'm going to pause the video for a second so I can try and figure out how this piece goes back together. Once I get it in, I'll restart it. Alright, got it back together. There's two little end caps here, and there's a pin that goes between. And the end caps means there's no hole to slide through. So, this should slide right back into the chamber, like it's supposed to. I should slip this other pin through here. So that goes in. Just in. Go. Well, slide action. I can't close this thing right now because of the fact that there's still air in here. I'm gonna have to keep it open because I can't pull the trigger while this thing is open up like this. Next comes the rear butt plate, or butt stock, I should say. Butt plate. Send it all the way. Dock should slide in like so. Should be. That's pin fill out. Check. Seems like it's supposed to be. Then, I'm trying to call how I took this apart. This piece out, but there we go. There's a small hole right here that this slides into to hold the stock in place. Reline this piece so it'll line up and goes into the hole like it's supposed to. From here, we need to also as a small adjustment. A small spring right here. This is not actually it is a spring, but what it does is for this for the pump handle. This piece goes right there. Just to line up on the other side. Work out correctly like it's supposed to. Loading piece. For the most part, this is actually going rather smoothly. this piece is going to slide back onto the rifle like this. From here, I'm going to put in, see now, screw in the back, smaller, just to the front piece, everyone goes there. See, as the screw's going to go here, screw this in. This screw holds this top barrel piece in. Second one goes here. Baby guns are a great way to get target practice in, though. From there, I'd definitely upgrade to a pellet gun because you get a lot more accuracy. But for beginners, I mean, it's great to teach lots of people on these guns right here. It's just such a fun rifle. Because, I mean, ammo should cost next to nothing. And from there, it's just relatively simpleness. I mean, it's a simple, well, not really that simple design you just saw. But, well, I don't think that should go through. This piece is going to go like this. Oh, crap. That makes sense, that's why these screws aren't going in straight. Oh, there we go, just one. Skip this one, mine. Just little tiny holes, these are things that blind into just right. Alrighty, ton. This one goes here. That long screw sticking out of the top, I don't think it goes there. It goes on the other side. I remember when I was younger, I'd shoot like hundreds of rounds out of these things daily. I mean, just little small targets, or like little pie plates that make great targets, because they give feedback when you hit them. I mean, you should take the shot and you hear the little dent or ding. You should go right through the tinfoil without any problem, so it's kind of satisfying. Well, it's like a beginner steel plate for center fire, except this is for BB guns. Alright, so this is where that long screw goes. Long screw goes right in here. But this one, it's right in there. Just goes through that little hole in the buttstock you saw. Just goes right into the other side. This gun is pretty much all plastic except for the trigger. This is the one from my old rifle. I put it up here. I thought that might be the problem, but it wasn't. So thankfully, I didn't need to replace that. Sometimes older guns can be a little finicky with certain things like that. Hold on, something here's not. This is not lining up right. Right here, something's not lined up right. I have to take that apart a little later.
Hold on, let me just pause the video for a second.